Just some days back, I was telling Apuroji and Amy, with the work. So I said, I think that morning I was thinking about Makrand Dave, the wonderful spiritual poet. I had gone to him when we made the first decision to make the ashram here. And wonderful, wonderful, very, very elevated soul. So, emne ek saras Gujarati ma, like, I think Atul bhai ne Abhay bhai ne majha aave to aave. I don't know if these kids will understand or not, but mane etlu badu gayam, which I have read only 2-3 books of his, and that too in 88-89. Sahajna Kinare ne eva betan books. Wonderful writer. It comes from his, from the soul, it seems. So beautifully he says, Meto veria beach chute hate. Meto veria beach chuta hate. Have vadal jane ne vasundra. So beautiful. Meto veria beach, you didn't understand anything? Apuruji ke translate karo hoye. મેં તો વેર્યા બીજ છૂટા હાથે હવે વાદળ જાણે ને વસુંધરા.
ધ રાઇટર ઇઝ સેઇંગ દેટ આઈ થ્રુ ધ સીડ્સ એવરીવેર એન્ડ નાવ ઇટ ઇઝ અપ ટુ ધ ક્લાઉડ્સ એન્ડ ઇટ ઇઝ અપ ટુ ધ અર્થ વેધર ટુ ગ્રો ધેમ. સો
The Sadguru is also saying, out of compassion, I have given you everything, O my disciple. Have tari patrata jane ne taro purushart. I have done my work. So now I am retiring because I have finished my work. You wanted to know the path of liberation? I have shown you. Me to verya beach. Chute hate. Didn't see time, didn't see anything. I chuta hate gnan dan kairu me. Have vadal jane ne vasundra. Clouds. Now my work is over. Have jetli tari patrata, jetlo taru purushat, e pramane phal pakshe. I didn't want to translate. Because the beauty is in these words. Me to verya. બીચ છૂટે હાથ તમને મોડે થઈ ગયું હશે એટલું સુંદર છે. અને એમની આ હતા પહેલાં આપણે ઘણા પદો પણ ગાઈએ છીએ એમના. હમણાં 2 દિવસ પહેલાં ગાયું હતું એટલે મને પાછું યાદ, 2 નહીં 4 દિવસ પહેલાં ગાયું હતું. વૃષાલીએ ગાયું હતું કે કોઈ આ નાંધની હતા, વિરાલીએ ગાયું. હા, સો ડ્યોરિંગ ધ ગુરુ દર્શન એન્ડ ઓલ, સો શી હેડ સંગ સો મેમરીઝ. સો મેં તો વેર્યા બીજ છૂટે હાથે હવે વાદળ જાને ને વસુંધરા. આ હેવ ડન માય જોબ સેલ્ફલેસલી વિથ ઇનર કમ્પેશન વિથ લવ ફોર યુ સીઈંગ યોર વર્ધીનેસ. આ હેવ ડન માય જોબ નાવ ઇટ્સ અપ ટુ યુ ઓ માય ડિસાઇપલ. ઇટ્સ અપ ટુ યુ યોર પાત્રતા એન્ડ યોર પુરુષાર્થ. યોર પાત્રતા એન્ડ યોર પુરુષાર્થ. હાઉ યુ વોન્ટ ટુ ગો અહેડ વિથ ધીઝ સીડ્સ. So today when I was leaving from the Sadhak Nivas, I met Jyoti Ben, and in a join I get instigated to say something. So inspired not bolto, instigate bolu chu special. To emne me kidu ke samlo ek kavita. Hu to am to kavi no shishya chu, hu to kai kavi chu nahi. I have nothing to do with poetry and all. I can't write for nuts, I can't even think in that way. But my guru. So, I was telling her, Sagli tayari karvi. Sadhana mate sagli tayari karvani. Dhoop deep ni tayari karvani. Mala, nityakram, puja, archana. Sagli tayari kari. Ane pachu kai nahi karu. Gnata drashta bhava. If you understand, you understand. It only means choiceless, effortless awareness. But sagli tayari karvi. Don't take anything for granted. Sagli tayari karvi, pachi kashu na karu. સવાર પડે ત્યારથી શું કરવાનું ખબર, ઊંડા શ્વાસ લેવા અને બધા ખ્યાલ ખંખેરવા, બીજું કાંઈ નહીં કરવાનું. ઓલ ધ આઈનેસ એન્ડ માઇનેસ સબટ્રેક્ટ. ઊંડા શ્વાસ લેવા અને પછી કે શું કયો જપ કરવાનો સાહેબ, મંત્ર તો આપો. સગલા ખ્યાલ છોડી દેવા, ખંખેરવા. કશું ન કરવું જો ઊંઘમાં હો સરકવું. ઊંઘમાં જો સરકવું હોય તો કશું ના કરવું. ઇફ યુ વોન્ટ ટુ સ્લીપ, યુ શુડ નોટ ઇવન થિંક ઓફ સ્લીપિંગ, ફોરગેટ અધર થિંગ્સ. કશું ન કરવું જો હોય ઊંઘમાં સરકવું. Choice lesson. When we had to cross the roads, you know, when I was small and my mom taught me how to cross the roads once. So, my loving mom. So, you know, Valkeshwarna rasta to ketla ekdam London jeva ekdam. London na hoi, na rasta. US jeva rasta nahi, London jeva. તો એટલું નાનું વાલ્કેશ્વરનો રસ્તો છે, પણ ક્રોસ કરવાનું હોય, હવે નોન સ્ટોપ વહીકલ્સ આવે. તો માય મોમ ટોટ મી ધીસ કે યુ હેવ ટુ સી ધ સ્પેસ બિટવીન ટુ વહીકલ્સ, અને જ્યાં એમ લાગે કે ધ સ્પેસ બિટવીન ધ ટુ વહીકલ્સ થોડું વધારે છે એવું લાગે, યુ હેવ ટુ જસ્ટ રન એન્ડ ક્રોસ. વોટ હેપન? સો માય મોમ ટોટ મી ધીસ એન્ડ માય ગુરુ ઓલ્સો ટોટ મી ધીસ. Between two thoughts, there is some empty space. Hold that space and be still within. Choiceless, effortless awareness. In 21 verses, through the Guru, Param Krupa Dev conveyed the fundamental nature of the path of liberation, a complete continuous sequence of attaining it in three mystical pinnacle verses over 15, 16 and 17. Now in this verse, 118, he concludes the dialogue. The dialogue is over now. The dialogue, he concludes the dialogue between the Guru and the disciple, which had commenced verse 45. Nati drashti ma avato nati janatu roop. That was the first thing the Shishya speaks, and the dialogue starts. And this is the verse where the dialogue ends. This is the last. So now in this verse 118, he concludes the dialogue between the Guru and the disciple that had commenced in verse 45. In this last verse that is addressed to the disciple, the Guru says,
Nishchaya sarve gnanino avi atra shamai dhari maunata em kahi sahaj samadhi mai.
Nishchaya, conclusion. Sarve gnani no, of all the enlightened ones, avi atra samai, converge at this point. The gist of all the teachings of all the enlightened masters has been encompassed here. Everything. And then, this is the last line the Guru is speaking. And then, dhari maunata, now he becomes quiet. He assumes silence. Em kahi, after saying this, sahaja samadhi mai, into deep meditative states, he goes, he slips, he enters effortlessly. Sahaj, effortlessly, he goes into deep meditative states. And this is the end of the dialogue. Short meaning. The conclusion of all the enlightened ones have been encompassed here. Having said this, the Guru assumes silence and enters into effortless self-absorption or deep meditative states or innate ecstasy, effortlessly. So I just need to explain the first line. And the Guru imparted the understanding of all the important aspects of the regarding the path of liberation, right? Starting from 97, the blessings, 97. Then you saw 98, what was it? karma bhav, moksha bhav, then 99 jeje karan, then 100 rag dvesha gnan, then 101 sat chaitanya mai sarvabhas, then 2 regarding monia, then 3 darshan monia and charitra monia, then 4 forgiveness and anger, anger and forgiveness, then 5 mat darshan agra thodi, and then shatpadni, you know, from total, from all the viewpoints, understand the 6 fundamental truths, then jati vaishno koi bhed nahi kayo mar, then the beautiful sequence from 108 to 113, then how much time, 114, then the 3 pinnacle verses 15, 16, 17, what is true religion, then what is the nature of yourself, then what is the nature of yourself. So everything beautiful, all the important aspects are catered. And he has nothing more to say regarding the path of liberation. So the last thing he says is, whatever is said by me in verse, in the last 21 verses, say from 97 to 117, because this being the 118th verse, whatever has been said by me is acceptable to all the enlightened masters of the present and the past. Present and past means all. Is acceptable to all. I have not said a single statement, not a single statement has been expressed by me which is contrary to the teachings of the enlightened ones of the past. You say ke navo dharma che, Shrimad nu navo dharma che. Shrimad say without addition and without subtraction, I've said exactly what is in the heart of the enlightened ones of your. Whatever, the essence of the teachings of all the enlightened masters have been encompassed. Atra. Atra means Shri Atmasiddhi Shastra. It converges in this. Of all the enlightened masters, their heart. Their hearts have been encompassed here. They converge here. So beautifully it said. As a matter of fact, there is only one path of liberation. Ek hoy tran kalma parmarathno pant. All enlightened ones are self-realized. So they all have only one opinion regarding the path of liberation. One Agnani has 100 mat, but 100 Gnanis have one mat, one opinion, because they have experienced it. So when you have experienced it, it may be expressed in different ways. What a wonderful evening if you had to express. Dr. Mansi would play the violin to express how beautiful today today's discourse was. Someone can paint, someone can compose a poetry, someone can just go into deep silence. These are the different forms of expression. But experience is same. So the gist of their teachings are all encompassed here, all converge here. They are all, the conclusions of all the enlightened masters have arrived here in this Sri Atmasiddhi Shastra. And if you study different scriptures, you will realize all this message is there in Sri Atmasiddhi Shastra. Meaning, whatever has been said as path of liberation is, remember this, is the universal message acceptable to all Gnanis of the present and the past. And why not future? All the infinite souls who have attained liberation, they have attained through this mark. Different places, different time, different external methods, means, rituals, but that doesn't matter. This is the universal message. How beautifully expressed in the first line. Nishchai sarva gnanino, nishchai, conclusion of all the enlightened masters, past, present, future. Let's keep it tranquil. Avi atra samai, they all converge in whatever is said by me in Shri Atmasiddhi Shastra. See the respect, the reverence. He could have said, no one but me have said this truth. He could have said it that way. Okay, see how beautifully I have presented the path of liberation. He's saying all what their enlightened masters have said, that universal message, oh my dear Shishya, disciple, I have expressed. So beautiful. Universal message sounds so beautiful. No, not confined to some sect and some ism. Universal message. I hope you have understood. So having said this, that all that he propounded, whatever he expressed, is acceptable to all the enlightened ones. He did not say all the monks and all the sadhus and all the priests. He said enlightened ones. But those who are not enlightened and, you know, they stick to the traditional beliefs, they might agree, not agree. Bau nischay ni vato che ne, bau shuddha swarup ni vato che ne, a che ne te che. But all the enlightened beings, it's acceptable to it. And this is the universal message. You understood? So I go to the second line. Dari maunata em kahi, having said this, nischay sarve gnani no avitra, having said this, now what happens? He assumes silence. Why? And then what after silence? Sahaja samadhi mai. Why? You need to understand that. So the guru ends his activity of speech, his discourse. He ends it, ends the activity, and slips effortlessly, gets absorbed in deep meditative states. Effortlessly. Why? That is the question. I explain this in 5 minutes and then. We need not go into the silence because we are not gurus, we are shishyas. We have to yet do the thank you. So that is another shibir, another yagna, the thanksgiving. Guru can go, he is selfless. He can go into mount, but yet we cannot go in mount. Every time we should not copy. We should not hurry. We should do our duty. Aho, aho, Shri Sadguru, Karuna, Sundhu Apar, and Amap Upkar Tame Mara Upar Karyo, Dehne Atma Bhinna Batavin. So the Guru may go. Why? Because the enlightened ones are primarily immersed in a state beyond thoughts, reveling in their self. Primarily. Then what happens? And whenever thoughts arise in them, what do? Impart religious teachings when thoughts arise. But primarily they want to revel in a state which is thoughtless, no mind state. You understand? And when thoughts arise, the good thing they do is impart religious teachings. But that's not their main activity. Dharma is their main activity, and when dharma is the main activity, it is to be engrossed in yourself. But if karmas manifest, if thoughts arise, then what they will do? Dharma prabhavana. They will impart religious teachings and training to their worthy disciples. So having seen the worthiness of the disciple, the guru, out of compassion, imparts religious teachings in a concise manner, sankshepma. Not 33 sagars, not countless years. In short, brief, concise. He imparts religious teachings. He solves his confusion, establishes firm conviction, and urges him to tread the path of liberation. Pursue it. So for the benefit of the disciple, the guru had resorted to speech. For the benefit of the disciple, because the disciple was confused. He had so many doubts. So the guru did not want to talk, but he could not see that person in such confusion. So instead of moan, he started speaking, solving his doubts, establishing conviction of the six fundamentals and urging him to pursue the path of liberation. Since that purpose is served, now he is clear about the five fundamentals. He did claim that apache uttarni thai atma vishe pratit, and with the six and with the constant clapping, I think even the disciple is now convinced regarding the sixth also. Right? So the guru says, now my work is over. I was speaking, I took up the activity of speech for your benefit. So now I switch over. Now my purpose is served. So now I go to withdrawal of speech. Activity of speech. So passionate when it came to activity of speech. So passionate when he had to end that activity and withdraw within. This is the state of a guru. આપણે તો જાણીએ તો આપણે બોલ બોલ કરવાનું જ મન થાય, ચૂપ રહેવાનું મન ન થાય. આમ કોઈ બોલતા હોય તો આપણે ઘડિયાળ દેખાડવી પડે. સો પેશનેટ વેન ઇટ કેમ બિકોઝ ઇટ વોઝ આઉટ ઓફ કમ્પેશન સીઈંગ ધ વર્ધીનેસ ઓફ ધ ડિસાઇપલ. નાવ દેટ પર્પઝ ઇઝ સર્વ્ડ. નાવ દેર ઇઝ નો નીડ. હી ડઝન્ટ હેવ અટેચમેન્ટ ફોર ધ શિષ્ય. સો વોટ વોઝ ટુ ડુ ઇઝ ડન. વોટ વોઝ નીડેડ ઇઝ ડન. So he's saying, I've said it all. Biju kahiye ketlu now. What more is like left to say? I've shown you all. And you have understood it well. Now it's your attachment that I should go on speaking. It's your attachment. Whatever is needed, I've given you all. I've shown you everything. All the locks can be opened by this master key. So, having said this, he ends the activity of speech, withdraws from it, assumes silence, goes into deep silence, that is withdrawal of the speech activity. And then what? Dhari maunata em kahi. After saying this, he assumed silence. Sahaja samadhi mai. Enters into deep meditative states. Sahaj, sahaj, effortlessly. Automatically, without any external dependency. He doesn't need to sit for meditation. Effortlessly, on its own accord, he enters into sahaj samadhi, innate ecstasy. Having said so, the dialogue ends. So this was the end of the third group, which started from verse 114. Ends at 118. First group, 92 to 107. Second group, 108 to 113. Third group, 114 to 118. So this is the end of the third group, end of the six fundamental truths, and end of the activity of speech by the Sadguru. So we end here. Let's sing.
निश्चय सर्वे ज्ञानिनो आवि अत्र शमाय धरी मौनता एम कही सहज समाधि माय.